feel my to be here and presence the land of the great stalwart of Indus movement Periyar, and my best wishes to you. Actually very sorry, I can't speak English fluently. That is why with my broken English I will try and sum up my notes. And थोड़ा थोड़ा हिंदी हो जाएगा बीच बीच में. Thanks to comrade Natarajan, comrade Bala Subramaniam, comrade Kirti, very good revolutionary song, comrade Murugan, comrade Manoharan, comrade Selvi, Naidu ji, and my friend Ravi Palur, Central Coordination Committee member of Revolutionary Cultural Forum, Caste and Nation Movement, is from Kerala and sometime from West Bengal. So for both states he will present. Then on behalf of Revolutionary Cultural Forum, you have planned to visit South Indian states to meet with you, to meet our friends, and to know what cultural movement is going on, what type of activities of cultural resistance to fascism is going on, and learn some lessons from the movements. So from 28th February Guntur, Andhra Pradesh, 21st February Hyderabad, 22nd Bangalore, 23rd, 24th, Hyderabad, Bangalore, Chennai, today Chennai, and tomorrow Trichur, Kerala. That is our program. Trichur, Kerala. So, actually, as a concomitant of class struggle, every class society will have another stream of culture known as people's culture. Thus arises from the culture of the oppressed and toiling masses that opposes the culture imposed by the ruling class. Culture is a complex thing. Actually, every class society, the superstructural level, the people's language, their literature, ceremony of marriage, all these things, उसको अपन क्या बोलेंगे, मिलकर कल्चर बनता है उसको. दिस ऑल कंप्राइजेस
द कल्चर,
है ना. सो व्हाट आई वांट टू से दैट इन आवर कंट्री इंडिया देयर इज मल्टी कल्चरल, मल्टी नेशनलिस्ट कल्चर, बट ruling class always impose that India is a nation, and ruling class, now the ruling class concept is a Hindu majoritarian concept, that Hindi, Hindu, Hindustan. And if we found that where is our root, then we found that ruling classes always believe that India is the land of religious leaders, saints, all these things. But idealist cultures is the land of idealist culture, religious culture, Vedic culture. But we know that 2500 years ago, the Lokayat Darshan, the Charvaks, Gautam Buddha, since the time, the non-Vedic culture, the culture rejects rebirth, the culture rejects the existence of God, the culture rejects religious thoughts. The culture promotes to raise questions. The culture encourages people to revolt against monarchy, revolt against Purohitan, clergy. So there has been two trends, two streams of culture, of cultural movement or ideological movement. One is Vedic culture, ruling class culture, another non-Vedic culture, the Lokayat Darshan, Charvak Darshan, Gautam Buddha, and in 8th century, you know that with the advent of Adi Shankaracharya, the Brahminist forces, the Purohit forces, the Brahmanvadi forces, at that time there is no Hindu religion, Brahmanism, Brahman religion. So the Brahmanvadi ruling classes, with their full vigor, they attacked Buddhist cultural values, they attacked the materialist stream of Lokayat stream. So nowadays, if you want to found the Lokayat books, Charvak's books, they are all destroyed. Devaprasad Chattopadhyay wrote the Lokayat that we know that the hatred of Brahminism against Lokayat. So through that we know that the power of Lokayat Darshan, power of Lokayat Darshan among people, among toiling classes, among oppressed classes. So the two streams struggle, class struggle always exists. The two stream of cultural struggles always exist. In 11th century, we know that in Karnataka, the rise of Vasvanna against caste system, against religious thoughts, and in Middle Ages, Guru Nanak, Kabir Das, Ravi Das, through this in Bengal, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and till 18th century, the two-line struggle of two streams of cultural thoughts was going on. In 18th century, what happened? After 1757's Palasi War, East India Company and British colonialists captured all over India. And under British colonialism, Lord Cornwallis introduced Permanent Settlement Act. Under Permanent Settlement Act, they have implemented Indian agrarian sectors under Jamindari, landlordism. They introduced landlordism in Mahalwari, in Jamindari, in Malgujari, whatever. I think in Madras Presidency there was Mahalwari system. So under the feudal system, under the landlordism, the caste system, the religious values of ruling classes, the patriarchy, hatred against tribals, hatred against Dalits is remaining, not finished. Like the ideologue of anti-politics, they said that British colonialist was very good. They have implemented so many rules, enacted so many laws for the betterment of Dalit and oppressed classes. But under British rule, there are so many tribal struggles. Actually, if we go through the struggle against British Empire, tribal struggle. So we know that 100 years before 1857's independence war, in Dumka, Jharkhand, Baba Tilka Maji of Santhal leader revolted first British East India Company, and with their bows and arrows fight armed struggle against British imperialists. After that, Lord Cleveland, the British governor of Dumka, captured him. A fierce battle was going on, and captured him and sting with horse, and kya bolte hain usko pura Dumka town mein usko ghumaya, and after that hanged him. So Tilka Majhi, Sidhu Kani Chand Bhairav, under the leadership of Birsa Munda, Munda revolt, Chuad Vidroho, there are so many tribal revolt against British, because British rule was very cruel, and British always preserved and nurtured feudal classes, jamidars, Brahminical jamidar forces against Dalit, against feudal lords. So it is the thought is wrong that British ruling was very good for oppressed people. What I want to say that the two stream of class struggle in cultural field emerged in our 18th century Renaissance, and ফার্স্ট জ্যোতিবা ফুলে হু ফট ফর শুদ্রাস, হ্যাঁ, জ্যোতিবা ফুলে বাইফ সাবিত্রীবাই ফুলে, অ্যান্ড শি ওয়াজ পায়োনিয়ার ফর গার্লস এডুকেশন, গার্লস অফ অপ্রেসড ক্লাসেস, অ্যান্ড সো মেনি হিউমিলেশনস দে ফেসড, অ্যান্ড জ্যোতিবা ফুলে সাবিত্রীবাই ফুলে, অ্যান্ড আফটার দ্যাট ইন সাদার্ন স্ফিয়ার ইন দ্য রোল অফ পেরিয়ার, হ্যাঁ, ইউ অল নো দ্য রোল অফ পেরিয়ার, দ্য ফিয়ার্স ব্যাটল এগেনস্ট ফেমিনিজম, ফিয়ার্স ব্যাটল. What I wrote in Periyar's book, autobiography, that from Kashi to Tamil Nadu, he always fought against Hindu religious books, Hindu religious values, all those things, you know. But what I want to express that in Tamil, whereas Periyar, Periyar was battling against Brahminical caste system, Brahminical thoughts for the oppressed people in Kerala, Ayankali, Sahodaran Ayyappan, Narayan Guru, and in Chhattisgarh, 19th century, Guru Ghasidas, he told that all men equal. Manke manke ek saman, ha, there is no differentiation, no bhajan, no inequality, so many social reformers, even Ishwarchand Vidyasagar in Bengal, though he was from Brahmin family, he fought for widow marriage, and he married his elder son to a widow. Due to this, the Brahmin Samaj boycott Ishwarchand Vidyasagar at Bengal, late 19th century. So there are so many social reformers who fought against religious thoughts, caste system, patriarchy. Along with Savitribai Phule, Fatima Sheikh, Savitribai Phule and Fatima Sheikh, both together founded, I think, 48 school for women. And those women, society tagged them Patita, and tortured by upper caste men, they shelter, they built the shelter home for that woman, the oppressed woman. Oppressed woman. Yeah. And Savitribai Phule and Jyotiba Phule formed the Satya Sodhak Samaj. So at that time, this thing was very revolutionary thing. Revolutionary. So the great leaders of Renaissance, not only they fought against caste system, but against patriarchy, against equality, against for humanity, social justice. These all values created our new India during independence days, against British imperialists, against landlord and against compradors. So since 200 years of battle, of struggle against British imperialists, the new India, the secular India, what we called in Hindi Ganga Jamni Taji, Bahultavadi Samaj, kya bolenge, polyvalent society, kya bolenge usko,
मल्टीकल्चरल,
हाँ, एक अच्छा वर्ड है उसका, इंग्लिश में मैं भूल रहा हूँ, बहुलतावादी समाज. सो देयर हाउ डे थाउजेंड थॉट्स फ्लरिश, एंड सो मेनी रिलीजियन, सो मेनी कास्ट, सो मेनी क्रीड, ऑल इक्वल एंड एग्जिस्ट इन वन कंट्री. सो दिस इंडिया इमर्ज्ड ड्यूरिंग अवर फ्रीडम स्ट्रगल. बट after 1857's revolt, British British thought that India, if they follow divide and rule policy, and British hated Muslims more. In 1857's independence war, Muslims in Indian army, in British Indian army, they revolted many places. And fierce struggle, they martyred so many, along with Hindus, but British wrongfully created
division among
division, and the dawn of 20th century with the inspiration of British Muslim League fought. And in 1915, during First World War, with the inspiration of British imperialists, Hindu Mahasabha fought. But Hindu Mahasabha was not fulfilled British desire. So, in 1925, under Savarkar, Vinayak Damodar Savarkar, is not we, he is not hero. Like fundamentalist, Hindu fundamentalist called that Veer Savarkar. And he surrendered, we know that in cellular jail he surrendered and came out from that jail. And Savarkar, Hedge war formed Rashtriya Swayamsevak Sangh.
RSS.
After formation of Rashtriya Swayamsevak Sangh, Dr. Munje was the close aide of Dr. Hedge war. And under British British's help, Dr. Munje attended the third roundtable conference in 1928 in London. After roundtable conference, he went to Italy and Germany, and he met Mussolini, Hitler, and he observed the fascist party, the black shot party, their drill, all these things. Then the concept of Shakha, RSS Shakha was developed. And he was very inspired with the development of Germany and Italy. And after returning from India, in Nagpur and in Pune, RSS formed Bhosle Military School. And Dr. Munje was the principal. So RSS since 1928-29 militarized, trying to militarize militarily Hindu people, Hindu youth. And Hedge war found Golwalkar, Sadasi Mohan Golwalkar, SM Golwalkar. Actually, the Sanghis are very much respect to Golwalkar. They called him Guruji. And well, if we go through the Golwalkar's group, we, our nationhood defined, then Golwalkar, some of the Hindu youth came to Golwalkar, and they expressed their desire to participate in Quit India movement. Then Golwalkar told that Hindu youth, should not waste your energy and blood against British imperialists. Our main enemy is the communist Muslims and Christians. So we should fight against them. We should prepare our battle against them. So again, along with this, Golwalkar in his book, Bunch of Thoughts, he clearly mentioned that the Hindustan, not Bharat, Hindustan is for Hindus, and all other people who wants to reside Hindustan, they must follow the rituals of Hindu, and Muslims have no citizenship right. Clear cut, he announced and mentioned in that. So if some our comrades said that this is the plot CAA introduce of CAA, NRC, NPR, under this plot they have implemented their liberalization policies. They sell LIC, railway, all other things. No friends. It is not plot. It is plot all. It is the part and parcel of whole plot of Golwalkar. So we should clearly observe the things. What was going on? So against Hindu and Muslim fundamentalist, and with the inspiration from Renaissance period, you know that after Soviet October Revolution in Southeast Asia, China, Indonesia, Malaysia, and undivided India, Communist Party formed. And under the leadership of Communist Party, the toiling masses organized, and they fought many struggles. Through the inspiration of Communist Party, in 1936, கம்யூனிஸ்ட் பார்ட்டி ரியலைஸ் தட் எ பவர்ஃபுல் கல்ச்சரல் மூமெண்ட் இஸ் வெரி நெசசரி பிகாஸ் சின்ஸ் 30s டிகேட் த டார்க்னஸ் வாஸ் ப்ரிவேல்ட் இன் யூரோப் யூரோப் இன் ஜெர்மனி இன் இட்டாலி இன் ஃபின்லாண்ட் இன் ஸ்பெயின் த ஃபாசிசம் வாஸ் ப்ரிவேல்ட் வித் த அப்பீஸ்மெண்ட் ஆஃப் செம்பர்லைன் த பிரிட்டிஷ் பிரைம் மினிஸ்டர் செம்பர்லைன் அண்ட் அமெரிக்கன் பிரசிடென்ட் தே சப்போர்ட்டட் ஹிட்லர் அண்ட் முசோலினி அண்ட் ஈவன் போப் போப் பிளெஸிங் bless 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 them ha huh? directly bless them so with this help the fascist first attacks Spain at that time of all the intellectuals like Roma Rolla Bertrand Russell of type of intellectuals author write writers poets they form international writers forum against fascism in Paris meeting and our Sajjad Zahir and Mulk Raj Anand two of our progressive intellectuals presented at the meeting participated at the meeting and after returning from Paris Sajjad Zahir wrote a beautiful novel London ki ek raat one night of London and Sajjad Zahir Mulk Raj Anand with the blessing of Rabindranath Tagore Munshi Premchand our most famous progressive writer of Hindi belt they formed progressive writer association in 1936 after that in Bengal in Jukt Pradesh UP in Punjab in southern India progressive writer association attracted so many writers outside communist party what I emphasize is that so many writers so many intellectual so many artists film artists they were attracted towards progressive writers association IFTA was formed in 1943 at Mumbai so progressive writers association IFTA attracted Uday Shankar the Asia's number one dancer folk dancer Uday Shankar Ravi Shankar sitar vadak Ravi Shankar told that IFTA I gave you my younger brother you utilized him so Ravi Shankar Uday Shankar Salil Chaudhary they prepared a ballet at the time of Bengal famine the man made famine the British British created the situation during second world war that the great famine happened in West Bengal undivided Bengal at the time of IFTA formed so many dramas films Dharti Ka Lal and one drama epic drama in Bengali Nawan means new crop and they highlighted the problem of land proportion the landless poor peasants question the feudal lords oppression so through the theater the songs They created a very good atmosphere in undivided Bengal and in southern India resulted we saw that after that the great Tebhaga movement in 1944 during 44-48 and the great Telangana movement kya bolte hai usko uprising so the role of cultural movement is very basic is very effective at the time of IFTA period Balraj Sahni even Raj Kapoor Shahadat Hasan Manto the famous film star Ashok Kumar inspired by IFTA period so all the people Sambhu Mitra so all the artists they have created so many dramas ballets and Uday Shankar performed a ballet Light of Asia all over India from Punjab Bengal Tamil Nadu Madras Presidency Travancore all they visited Light of Asia and it's IFTA's ballet Uday Shankar like dancer Asia's most famous dancer so at that time, and Umar Ali from Maharashtra. The IFTAs, we have to learn lessons from LIFTA and Progressive Writers Association. But after 1947, our revolutionary जो सपना देखे थे their dreams was not fulfilled, not fulfilled. And in after 56-58-60 period, the internationally communist movement
set back.
In 1956, 20th Congress of Soviet Union, and with the advent of Khrushchev, the peaceful coexistence line, peaceful transition line, all over the world, the proletarian forces, the communist forces, the progressive forces face setback. And in our India, split in the Communist Party happened, and IFTA after 57-58, Habib Tanvir type actors, they came out to IFTA and Progressive Writers Association. So many writers, Samaresh Basu, the famous novelist of Bengal, they came out and they become professional writer, professional artist. So we have to learn from the IFTA period, and there are so many attempts to reorganize progressive leftist artists in the Jannata Mandali, Jannata Manch, Prajanata Mandali, so many express Jan Sanskritik Manch, AILRC, not sustained. Actually, friend, I am extremely sorry that we have to catch the train at 9 o'clock. That is why in brief. I have to mention. So, what we found that after during 1970s decade, internationally, the welfare policy of imperialism not implemented, and with the advent of Thatcher in England and in Reagan in America, they cut the social welfare policies and they have implemented neoliberal policies. So in our India, in 90s decade, the then ruling class, the then ruling party of Congress party, they implemented globalization, liberalization, privatization policy. And we called the new, this is the new colonial phase. Why we called the new colonial? Because the colonial culture with the feudal culture during colonial days, after the transfer of power, imperialist behind the curtain. They transfer of power to their comprador class. So the culture of India, the new colonial culture, actually, if we observe the 90s culture, at the same time in India, the feudal, semi-feudal culture is emerged. Sati Pratha type, child marriage exists, all these things exist. With this, the Coca-Cola culture, with the waste, and all neo-colonial culture penetrated like flood water. And through media, patriarchy is very strong. Through media, the neo-colonial culture has adopted the casteist, most retrogressive culture, the reactionary culture, the feudal culture with the neo-colonial culture. So nowadays, what we saw that one side, in among youth, ruling class created gang culture. If you observe Hindi films, mainstream Hindi films like Ab Tak Chhappan, Ab Tak, all glorifies mafia don culture, mafia doll culture, free sex culture, and anarchist culture. So the gang culture has been prevailing among youth and among girls. Ramp culture. In 1984, both our girls, Susmita Sen
Sushmita Singh, and Aishwarya Rai. The third world countries girls emerged as Miss World, Miss Universe. They were the pioneer. The Sushmita Singh and Aishwarya Rai. After that, Venezuela girl, South Africa girls. Before that, European American girls, Miss Asia, Miss Universe. So the market penetrated each and every village, each and every home of ours, in our school, in our college, gang culture, ram culture. In 90s, beginning of 90s, the Ramayana serial and Mahabharata serial, Ramanand Sagar and B.R. Chopra, they have created a wave of religious thoughts. And after that, Jai Hanuman, Jai Jai Shiv Shankar. Now we saw in Chota Bhim, like cartoon and all these things from childhood to old age person are affected with this culture. If we buy a blade or motorcycle or shirt, the media use female body as a commodity. You understand me? My English, please hear with me. As a in neocolonial phase, the degradation of woman is most rampant. Each product, whether it is blade or motorcycle or shaving cream, what or soap, they used woman's body as a commodity. And market has media, the multinational market, multinational media created a commodity market of, and that is why we saw 19 and this era atrocities against women, like Nirbhaya, like Dr. Reddy in Hyderabad, increasing. And with the neocolonial culture, pornography is penetrated, cyber crime, all these things. I think Comrade Natarajan explained the digital part in Tamil. So, Comrade, now India faced the darkest era, darkest challenge. Why I mentioned? Because due to soft Hindutva of Congress, all religious bourgeois party and their practice, the menace of fascism become vastvik ho gaya, actual reality, become a reality. And the fascist culture, like if you read Hitler's Mein Kampf, Hitler in this Hitler's biography, we saw that Hitler mentioned that women have the role in household, kitchen, and produce balshali Arya, balshali macho Arya santan.
Strong Arya.
Aryans. आप उसको जोर-जोर से बोल देना, कोई भी मेरा वर्ड कोई हो. हाँ. तो so women in Hindi we told that women are become बच्चा पैदा करने की मशीन. So they actually adopted the Hitler's line. So the Rashtriya Swayam Sevika Dal, prepared a manual for how to maintain good household, how to अपने पति को खुश कैसे रखें,
how to make happy
husband, their husband and their in-laws. So they prepared manual and they has been organized training session, the Rashtriya Swayam Sevika, the female wing of Rashtriya Swayam Sevak Sangh. And along with this, the उनका एक जो और वो है, क्या बोलते हैं, महिलाओं का सेना है, हानी सेना, उसको आम ट्रेनिंग भी दे रहे हैं. along with this they trained woman squad arm training and in this the Bhosle military school of Nagpur and Pune played pioneer role. In 30s they formed Bhosle military school, and neither British government, neither Nehru or any other government shut down the Bhosle military school. And RSS Shakha, RSS created thousands Saraswati Shishu Mandir. You know, in Kerala, the strong base of RSS, because they created Bala Gokulam. So since childhood, the Hindutva ideology, the poisonous ideology, hatred against Muslims, minorities, hatred against Dalits, the Chitwapa, the RSS followed the Peshwa principle. Peshwas, Chitwavan Brahman formed RSS. So their hatred is ekdam distinct, obvious. Their hatred against Dalit, tribal, ekdam spasht ka to ghina hai, nafra.
It's very clear.
So now the era, the darkest era we faced, and if anyone feels that they voted against BJP and BJP defeated, the problem is solved. It is not that easy. After Atal Bihari Vajpayee, 10 years of Congress alliance rule.
UPA.
But after that, in 2014, Modi came with powerful blow. And in 2019, Modi too. This transcendence is not ordinary development. Actually, this fascist onslaught, fascist emerges.
Yes.
It is not only vote box politics. It is in people's mentality, their psyche,
thoughts,
the thought process. Actually, in 2014. Before election propaganda, we discussed so many intellectuals, so many people in northern India. They told that we want a messiah, a dictator, so corruption,
a savior,
who controls corruption, who controls bad things.
Yes.
We want savior, and Narendra Modi shown this path to Gujarat. So the corporate media has created the myth of Gujarat. Is it only a balloon? Level of literacy, malnutrition level, they all down.
What is Gujarat model we have seen by making wall
Sardar. Yes, wall. So the corporate wants a lathai. Landlord, jamidar. जमींदार लोग लठैत रखता था, क्या बोलेंगे लठैत को, देर मसल में, देर मसल में, हाँ, टू 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 बीट द टेनेंट हु रिफ्यूज टू पे टैक्स और द टाइप ऑफ थिंग. एवरी लैंडलॉर्ड, एवरी जमींदार सम हैव सम मसल मैन
लाइक दैट हेंचमैन,
हेंचमैन. सो द कॉर्पोरेट फाउंड न्यू हेंचमैन मोदी और आरएसएस. So, because they want that 100, 200, 500% of guarantee of their profit, their mountain of profit, they preserve their mountain of profit, the Ambani Adani. So the corporate culture, actually corporate media created the corporate culture. So we face now the corporate culture along with feudal culture and increasing the role of patriarchy, all these things. In internationally, this phenomena is prevailing internationally. In the contemporary world, we find imperialist powers headed by USA have been supporting and instigating all sorts of communal, fundamentalist, arch-rightist forces, including military juntas, in every nook and corner of the world. beat governments of Turkey or in Israel, Bolsonaro, our Republican Day chief guest, or Israel, Myanmar, Pakistan, India, and so many East European countries, or those like governments of Africa, Asia, or those phantoms created by Taliban, Al-Qaeda, or the latest coalesced apparition known as ISIS. For the present painful situation in Syria and most of the Middle East, it is the world imperialist camp led by USA who happens to be responsible in some way or other. So actually the imperialist crisis increasing day by day, the finance capital crisis. So fascist governments took over all over the world. It is international phenomena. So in India is the continuation. And nowadays, what they created, they introduced CAA, NRC, NPR, and before that, the Ram Janmabhoomi verdict, Teen Talaq verdict, Kashmir, the open jail in Kashmir, and looping the 370, Dhara 370, all these things. Gradually and now CAA, NRC, NPR, they want to create, they want to isolate Muslims like Hitler handled Jews in 1935 at Nuremberg. So they dream that majority people rejected minority, and there was a drift among Hindu and Muslims. And they easily overcome and they easily overthrow the Muslims. First Muslim, then Christian, Dalit, all. But with the suppression of Jamia student, 15 December 2019, the rage, the outrage among the minority people, especially Muslim people, and women against fascism, a new phenomena. Student against fascism, a new phenomena. I was in Delhi, there was a slogan, Hum na Hindu na Musliman, Hum hai Fatima Sheikh, Savitribai Phule ki Santan. So this type of secular demand, secular songs, secular story, secular rhetoric, type of things, and in 1921 Asahyoga, non-cooperation andolan type mood prevailing in people of India. And Hindu Muslim unity, all progressive peoples, minority peoples, Dalit people, tribal people, OBC people, and there's a possibility against most of the oppression against fascism. But what we envisage that without a strong progressive democratic secular cultural movement, the thought process of people, in people's thought process, the feudal things, casteist things, anti-woman things, anti-Muslim things. So many educated persons have the reactionary things, anti-Muslim, anti-Muslim, anti-woman things. So we need a powerful, strong, democratic, progressive cultural movement. It should a broad-based cultural movement. Not a pocket organization like IPTA. IPTA become a pocket organization of CPI, and Jannatta Mandali become the pocket organization of CPM. We all know that. Yes. But in our RCF, we discussed that we have to create a broad-based cultural forum, and we have learned.
It should not be in any pocket of any organization,
and we have to learn from IPTA period. We have to learn the our Renaissance leaders, and we have to wage struggle against fascism from the lessons of Renaissance. Phule, Periyar, Ambedkar, Bhagat Singh, we have to learn
even
from them.
Buddha, Charvaka,
Lokayat Darshan. So, the task before the progressive forces is to resist the neo-colonial culture that spreads all around decay and degeneration on the one hand and dominates the culture of the whole society, suppressing the real culture created and has become part of the life of the majority of the people. On the other, instead, the progressive stream of culture, the culture of resistance and rebellion, that is the product of class struggle that is latent in society and people's lives, and that is being silenced by the authoritarian culture, is to be identified and nurtured. So, we have to create a broad-based progressive cultural movement, and we have to create coordination among progressive cultural organization, and we have to evolve newer and newer strategy, tactics against fascism. So, the cultural resistance is the need of the hour, and it should not be that cultural organization's leadership of should not be the communist leadership.
Yes.
Of any party's leadership. We have to attract our outside organizations, outside intellectual, writers, poets, artists, script writers, actors, film artists. So most of the people are outside from our camp.
It should not be a partisan.
Yeah, should not be a partisan. So, and in our struggle, we have to fight against IND politics, the NGO politics, the postmodernist politics, post-colonial thoughts that spread. They mentioned that ideology, the end of ideology. There is no need of ideology. And
the post-truth period.
Yes. They highlighting that Dalit should fight alone. Tribal should fight alone. Women should fight alone. And the piecemeal solution, they found always piecemeal solution. But we know that in the imperialist era, in our neo-colonial phase, we know that all struggle linked. And now the struggle against NPR, National Population Register, is imminent, is a threat. Because from 1st April to 30th September, they have to complete their National Population Register. And in our estimate, apart from Muslim people, the Dalit, Adivasi and left section, 10 to 15 crores become stateless. So, in our cultural movement, we have to create strategies to boycott NPR, to boycott fascist onslaught, to fight fascist onslaught. We have to organize women, we have to organize Dalit, Adivasis, all people. And we have to create cultural squads, folk cultural groups, mass song groups, and culturally we have to fight against fascism. Actually, again, I'm sorry that I can't speak English fluently, but it is a need of the hour. It is not one's responsibility, all of our responsibility to create a progressive, democratic, secular cultural movement for a casteless and classless society, for a society without exploitation, without patriarchy, a equal society.
A just society.
That's all. And my first interaction. Thank you very much, comrade. Thank you very much, friends. Greetings. Hindi and Urdu mix. The song is written by famous poet Adam Gondvi, people's poet of our Hindi poet, Hindi belt. Adam Gondvi's song. दोस्त मेरे मजहबी नगमात को मत छेड़ी दोस्त मेरे मजहबी नगमात को मत छेड़ी हिंदू या मुस्लिम के एहसासात को मत छेड़ी हिंदू या मुस्लिम के एहसासात को मत छेड़िए छेड़िए एक जंग मिलजुल कर गरीबी के खिलाफ छेड़िए एक जंग मिलजुल कर गरीबी के खिलाफ। दोस्त मेरे मजहबी नगमात को मत छेड़िए, हिंदू या मुस्लिम के एहसासात को मत छेड़िए, अपने कुर्सी के लिए जज्बात को मत छेड़िए। दोस्त मेरे मजहबी नगमात को मत छेड़िए, हम में कोई हूड़ कोई शक कोई मंगोल है, हम में कोई हूड़ कोई शक कोई मंगोल है, खत्म है जो बात तो उस बात को मत छेड़िए। दोस्त मेरे मजहबी नगमात को मत छेड़िए, हिंदू या मुस्लिम के एहसासात को मत छेड़िए। है कहाँ हिटलर हलाकू जारे या चंगेज का, है कहाँ हिटलर हलाकू जारे या चंगेज का, खत्म है जो बात तो उस बात को मत छेड़िए, खत्म है जो बात तो उस बात को मत छेड़िए। दोस्त मेरे मजहबी नगमात को मत छेड़िए, हिंदू या मुस्लिम के ऐसा साथ को मत छेड़िए। गलतियां नेता करे निर्धन का घर ही क्यों जले, गलतियां नेता करे निर्धन का घर ही क्यों जले, ऐसे नाजुक वक्त पे हालात को मत छेड़िए। दोस्त मेरे मजहबी नगमात को मत छेड़िए, हिंदू या मुस्लिम के एहसासात को मत छेड़िए, अपने कुर्सी के लिए जज्बात को मत छेड़िए। छेड़िए एक जंग मिलजुल कर गरीबी के खिलाफ, छेड़िए एक जंग मिलजुल कर गरीबी के खिलाफ। दोस्त मेरे मजहबी नगमात को मत छेड़िए, हिंदू या मुस्लिम के एहसासात को मत छेड़िए। दोस्त मेरे मजहबी नगमात को मत छेड़िए।
இன்றைய சூழ்நிலையில் கலையிலக்கிய பண்பாட்டு அமைப்புகள் அதனுடைய செயல்பாடுகள் எப்படி இருக்க வேண்டும் என்பதற்கான ஒரு சிறிய ஆரம்பத்தை நாம் வந்து கூட்டியிருக்கோம். தோழர்கள்
நீங்க
என்ன
ரவி ரவி பால் ரவி ரவி
அது